Today, I'd like to introduce a new model called DreamOmni2. It is a multimodal model that integrates both generation and editing. Compared to traditional object-driven image generation models, its biggest feature is its ability to understand abstract content. For example, materials, textures, makeup, hairstyles, postures, design styles, art styles, and so on. In this video, we will thoroughly test its generation capabilities and image editing capabilities. The greatest advantage of this model lies in image editing, especially the editing of abstract content. Therefore, we will combine 7 very important scenarios to comprehensively test its editing capability. These scenarios include person replacement, light and shadow transfer, style transfer, pose transfer, hairstyle transfer, expression transfer, and material transfer. What you are seeing now is the GitHub page for DreamOmni2. Here, we can see some basic information for local deployment. Of course, if you want to use it within ComfyUI, you can try the extension made by Running Hub, which is called RHDreamOmni2. We can also follow its installation steps to install this extension into our ComfyUI. The installation steps are actually quite standard. We go into the custom node directory, clone the repository, and install all the dependency packages. Then, we need to download many models. Regarding model downloading, we can see a lot of information. For instance, here we have a model that is very familiar to everyone called Flux Context Dev. This model was trained based on Flux Context, and it underwent joint training with our visual language model. Therefore, this model will have a greater advantage in understanding abstract concepts. You can download all the models and deploy them according to the directory structure. Regarding model downloads, there are specific links provided here. I have also built all the workflows onto Running Hub. You can access this platform through runninghub.ai in the field of ComfyUI. Running Hub is a fantastic online workspace because as soon as new technologies or extensions emerge, it follows up immediately. You can register for Running Hub using the invitation link in my video description, which will grant you 1,000 free points. Furthermore, logging into Running Hub every day will give you an additional 100 points, allowing you to try out your own workflows. As we just mentioned, this model primarily has two main functions. One is generation and the other is editing. Now, let's first look at the generation function. Since this extension itself was officially developed by Running Hub, you can use it directly on the platform. The core node here is the one called the DreamOmni2 generator. This is the node specifically used for generation. It requires loading a pipeline. This pipeline is also called the generator pipeline. We have 3 reference images. This is quite similar to QWR2 Gwen image 2509. What we are testing now is simple multi-subject generation. We have 3 images, 2 beautiful women and 1 cat. My prompt is also very simple. 2 girls are talking and 1 girl is holding a cat in her arms. Let's look at the generated result. I think the consistency of the characters is acceptable, though these types of models are generally not exceptionally strong at it. The girl wearing the headphones actually looks quite similar. However, this character is actually not very similar. The reason is simple. The Flux model itself has its own unique characteristics, including certain tendencies in rendering people. For example, if you look, the people tend to look quite glossy, right? And the chin is relatively prominent. These are some rendering characteristics of the Flux model and the Flux context model. But anyway, the character consistency is maintained reasonably well, and the cat being held in the arms is also fine. Next, let's conduct a more complex test. In this workflow, I assigned a name to each person in the images. The girl in image 1 is called Lucy, the girl in image 2 is called Lily, and the cat in image 3 is called Tom. We have discussed this method in previous videos. This way, I can write the action to be much more complex. My prompt reads, Lucy and Lily are chatting happily, and Tom is currently in Lucy's arms. If you look at the generated result, the drawbacks are quite obvious. Firstly, the characters do not look very similar. Although conceptually, the headwear and the clothing seem to be imitating the characters, the similarity level is indeed very low. Furthermore, you should note, the body proportions are problematic. This girl is kneeling on the blanket, and her legs going downward show a general distorted representation, and this one simply has no legs, right? So, this is a significant drawback. However, it is undeniable that it executed the complex instruction. The cat is indeed in Lucy's arms. Thus, it does support complex instructions, but in terms of executing complex instructions, it doesn't seem to perform as well as QWImage. In its official paper, there are two very specific scenarios mentioned. One is hairstyle reference generation. I currently have two images. Suppose my prompt is to take the girl in image 1 and give her the same hairstyle as the girl in image 2. You should note that the result I got now was not very ideal. It didn't work. But later, I found that this function isn't missing, it is because the hairstyle of the girl I chose might be uncommon. If we switch now, we change image 1 to a Western beauty, and the girl in image 2 has a high ponytail hairstyle. We make no changes to the prompt. Then, I get a much better result. The consistency is also good, and the hairstyle was indeed transferred. Furthermore, there is another example worth paying attention to pose-driven generation. I now have an image like this, showing two figures performing certain actions. Of course, this is in the form of a simple sketch. These two figures are a boy and a girl. The prompt is very simple. I want to show them boxing in a boxing ring, with the girl on the left and the boy on the right. Their poses should be consistent with the third image. Now look at the generated result. It is not very ideal. I ran this test many times, and the result was never very satisfactory. I feel that in terms of pose-driven character generation, it still lags behind qwimage. Because we know qwimage 2509 comes with ControlNet, which makes its recognition of poses relatively accurate. So, that concludes the first feature we discussed, image generation capability. Image generation capability is actually not what this model excels at. What it excels at most is image editing capability. Alright, next we will use 7 major scenarios to demonstrate its image editing ability. First, let's look at the differences in the workflow. The node has changed. Now, this node is called the DreamOmni2 editor, an editing node. The pipeline is also different. The previous one was specifically for generation, while this one is for editing. There aren't as many images either. There are only 2. One is the source image, called SRC images, and one is the reference image, called reference image. Okay, let's look at the first function, person replacement. Here is a poster. This poster is actually quite complex because it has text in front of it. Now, my prompt is very simple, replace the man in the first image with the woman in the second image. Let's look at the generated result. First, let's look, most of the text was preserved, but it was not completely preserved. Notice that it is different. The middle line was lost. Additionally, the person was successfully transferred. The consistency is maintained reasonably well, but it is not exceptionally high. Nevertheless, I think the capability for this kind of replacement is very strong, especially given the text overlay. The fact that it can perform replacement to this extent fully demonstrates this model's unique capabilities in image editing. Alright, next we look at the second scenario. The second is called light and shadow replacement. This is a feature that many models may not possess. Now, we have one image here, and here is a reference image. Note that the prompt we wrote is also simple. Transfer the light and shadow from the second image onto the first image. Let's look at the result. Wow, this effect is also superb. However, the change made to the first image is quite significant, because in the first image, the person is lying on the sofa, but in the result, that scene is completely gone. Therefore, this is a type of reconstruction editing, rather than simple in-painting local drawing editing. Next, let's look at style transfer. Many models have this, so we'll just quickly look. This is the source image. This is the reference image. My prompt asks for the first image to have the same style as the second image. The result is also excellent and very detailed. Since this function is quite common, we won't dwell on it. Alright, the next one is pose transfer. Again, we have two images. The prompt is very similar. We want the character in the first image to maintain the same pose as the character in the second image. Let's take a look. The character hasn't changed, otherwise only the pose has changed. Also, note that in some details, it is influenced by the reference image. For example, this person is wearing a ring on their hand. Look. This is also reflected in the result. Next, let's look at an even more interesting function. It is called hairstyle replacement. We already tested hairstyle reference generation when we tested the generation function. Replacement is actually more interesting. For example, here is a beautiful woman, and here is a hairstyle that is unique to ancient China. Our prompt still follows the same pattern, make the person in the first image have the same hairstyle as the person in the second image. Let's look at the result. I think this effect is very beautiful. The hairstyle transfer is not a complete transplant, but it captures the characteristics of the hairstyle very accurately. Also, you should note that the original image itself had some flaws when generated. A large head and a small body. After the transfer, this still affects the target image. The ratio of the body and head is disproportionate. Now, let's look at expression transfer. I think this is also very interesting. Here is the image of the beautiful woman. This is the expression reference image we want to transfer. I won't read the prompt. It has the same structure. Now, look at this result. Isn't that very interesting? I think the expression is perfect and the character consistency is well maintained. Finally, let's look at this function, material transfer. This is a feature that many models likely do not have. Here's an image of a beautiful woman and a luxury car. And here is a mouse. The surface of this mouse has a material that resembles fireworks. Now, I want to transfer this material onto the car. Therefore, my prompt still follows the previous pattern. The car in the first image should have the same material as the mouse in the second image. Now look at this result. It is very beautiful. I think the transfer is very well executed and the consistency is very strong. So we have generally completed tests across 5 generation scenarios and 7 editing scenarios. I think the capability of this model is very impressive. At the very least, it is on par with the QEE Image 2509 model. Currently, the only drawback when using it is that the sampling speed is relatively slow. We hope that subsequent quantized models or GAF models will emerge. This would make its usage simpler and faster. Well, what are you waiting for? Try it out yourself. Follow me to become someone who understands AI.